everybody. So I'm Titi and Nike's mom. I'm here to present something that I think everybody has seen and touched before every day of your life. Every day. So I'm going to present. I heard that you are learning about museums, and there are all kinds of things in museums, right? So today I'm going to share about something that, again, you can see, you can touch, you can, every day of your life. So, can somebody guess what goes into a suitcase?
Animals!
Animals! A suitcase? No, they get it. They go in like cages, like pet cages.
Yeah.
What can go in a suitcase? Can
a someone guess? Textiles. Can someone say textiles?
Textiles.
Okay, great. So they study fabric, all kinds of fabric, because even clothes come from fabric. So I have a lot of different kinds of clothes from different places in the world. That's why I brought a map. Where are we? Where are we in the world? What city are we in right now? Berkeley, yes. So Berkeley is right over here where that Golden Gate Bridge is. So I am going to put a little sticker right there so you can see where we are in the world. And then as I cover every kind of thing I have, either here in the books from the library or here in the suitcase, I'll be adding stickers. Okay? All right. So the first place where, okay, so we are going to buckle up. When you go on an airplane, you need to buckle up. So, okay, buckle up your seatbelt.
Mary,
buckle up your seatbelt. Yes. And then raise a hand. I don't care which hand you raise. Okay, now spread out your five fingers. And then your middle finger goes down and your fourth finger. And you're going to fly. We're going to fly. And we're going to fly over here. This is Arizona. So. The first place we're going to look at is Arizona. So, who knows anything about Arizona?
Me!
Okay, can you tell me can you tell me about Arizona?
Me,
one
me!
Thing you know about Arizona?
Call help is out here.
Oh, okay. All right, so it's right next to California. This is where we live. However, it's really hot, okay? So, and I borrowed a book from the library that talks about Southwest textiles, because this is the Southwest, it's south and it's west of the United States. This is where we are. So, and they specifically talk about Navajo and Pueblo textiles. So Navajo and Pueblo are some people who live in this area of the United States. And this book covers things that they've made a long time ago, and things that some people still use. And so this is the first page. This is a blanket. So you see a lot of designs that, what kind of designs do you see? Like a diamond? What else? Like zigzag and stripes, right? So these are all hand woven on a loom. A loom is just two sticks with a lot of strings connecting the sticks, and they're weaving these patterns out of just two sticks and a lot of strings. Okay, so this isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
So yeah, let's find out other patterns. Wow, this lots of diamonds here, right? Lots of diamond shapes here, and a lot of lines in between. Isn't that interesting?
No.
I find it interesting that they can make all these designs out of just two sticks and all these strings. Oh, and this looks like river, huh? Like water?
Yeah.
Like all these zigzag lines. So these are all Navajo designs. This looks kind of like a chain link fence when it's like connected.
And that one looks kind of like mountains on fence.
Yes, doesn't it? Yeah, so lots of blankets. Here's a picture of a woman who in the 1900s, that's over 1,000 years ago. Over 1,000 years ago, wearing some of these clothes. And here's an example of what the women wore. Like they would use these cloths to wrap around themselves to wear. Isn't that interesting? These were how skirts looked like back then. And some, even today, some people still style the skirts like that. Isn't that interesting? Yeah, so there's lots of examples. And then we'll go to the next section where, let's see, there's more blankets. And I'll even get to show you what a baby blanket looks like soon. Okay, so this is traditional. These are really traditional, meaning like a long time ago. These patterns came from a long time ago. And there's a lot of solid colors. In fact, the Navajo were so well known for their hand-woven blankets that even other people from farther places also bought their clothes, their blankets. And so there's a lot of different designs. And as you can tell, from here to here, it's getting more and more, there's more and more shapes, right? There's rectangles, there's even bigger rectangles and bigger stripes. There's actually even more colors. It's getting more and more complex, more and more design, more and more art, right? So there's a lot of different, there's a lot of changes going on as these cultures of people, they talk to one another and they, create new things. And it's very bright, the colors are getting more bright and more colorful. So lots of blankets. I have a mommy. Okay. Oh, and then at some point, people decided, oh, this blanket is not just for wrapping around myself when it's cold, because it can be really cold at night and then really hot during the day. At some point, they decided, wow, we can make rugs. We can make rugs out of these. So, so this is a blanket rug. These are blanket rugs now that we're looking at. A lot of blanket rugs. Isn't that interesting? What else can you make out of fabric? Out of things that...
A blanket.
A blanket? A comforter? Somebody said a comforter.
You could a pillow?
A pillow or a pillowcase, you know. And you could even make a purse, right? Because purse comes, you make purses out of fabric. So yeah, so as people talk with one another and they grow together, then they create new ideas about what to do. And so I wanted to show you the picture of, so these are still Navajo designs. And then so now we're gonna go to the Pueblo designs, and then at some point I'll be able to show you the baby blanket. Let's see, where am I? Sorry, I can't read my numbers upside down sometimes. All right, so three. All right. So here's, so now we're gonna start looking at the Pueblo. So here's a really old picture. Again, this comes from 1,000 years ago. You see these two sticks, like one up in the air, like tied to a tree, and one near the ground, and then all these strings in between. That's how big the blanket will be, between the two sticks and the strings. That's how big this blanket will be. This is what they call an upright loom, a weaving loom. So, so this is a picture of how they worked. This is a Pueblo design, and just like we live in California, some people live in Oakland, some people live in Berkeley. So, so even the Pueblo, they had different people living in different areas, and they called themselves different names. So This is a Zuni Pueblo blanket. And there's another blanket. So at first it started with really simple designs. And then they were able to add more color and more brightness to it and more complicated designs, more art. And then there's more shapes too. The lines aren't really just lines now, it's zigzags. A group of zigzag lines that create a really big line. And here's a really big diamond in between.
Big diamond.
And then there's in the diamond, there's like, and it's not just straight edge, it's like zigzag edge of the diamond. And then inside there's like a plus sign.
Nike.
So yeah, there's a lot of like, and let's see, hold on. Where is the, okay, great. And then I wanted to show you the baby blanket. 3, 5. Okay, so here's this blanket. It was used to wrap up a baby. And this is an old Teacher Tanisha because it's black and white. And it's also almost 1,000 years old, almost. Oh no, I mean, 100. Okay, I'm saying the wrong number.
Right.
100 years old. Sorry, it's almost 100 years old. That kind of picture. Okay, so and then here's another picture of an upright weaving loom. So here's one stick of ground and all these strings in between. And this person is almost done with their project. You see that this part of the blanket is done. This part of the blanket is done. And there's just all these strings in between that he's filling with more string, you know, to finish that up. Isn't that interesting? So the Navajo and the Pueblo, they used weaving looms to create their art, their clothes, their blankets, their rugs. And so now, okay, we're gonna buckle up our seatbelts again and fly to another area. And then, okay, now raise a hand. I don't care which hand. All right, just one hand, and then I want you to put your middle finger and your fourth finger down. And then we're gonna fly. We're gonna fly, okay. And then now we're gonna fly to another area that's very close to the United States, but this time we're going to fly to, I can't find Hawai'i on here. It's here somewhere. It's here somewhere. It's here somewhere off the map. It's supposed to show up on the other side, but I don't see it right now. So just imagine that you're in Hawai'i. Okay, so Hawai'i. I had a period of time when I was asking my friends, if you go someplace outside of the United States, can you please bring me back some fabric? And so when one of my friends went to Hawai'i, who has never been to Hawai'i?
Me.
Oh, you have heard of it. Okay, good. Great. So this is a cloth that she brought back. So as you can tell, it's very colorful. Has a lot of designs. And these are plumeria blossoms. This kind of flower is called a plumeria. And it folds out to this big. And she actually told me that it's designed to wrap around the waist. And so some people, yeah, so you just kind of wrap it around. And then if you can tie it. And since I've gained a little weight in my belly, I can't tie it around anymore, you see? Like, so instead of tying it, so you can actually curl it, like wrap it down, like, and tuck it in, tuck the ends in, and then it stays up. It stays up. So it doesn't matter if you get too full and your pants get too tight. Like you can loosen it, or you know, like this is the kind of cloth that you can use to, wrap yourself. So this is from Hawai'i. So I'm going to pass this around if you want to feel. It's very soft. I forget what it's made of. I think it's cotton. So if you want to touch it, pass them on. That's fine. Just don't put it on the floor or toss it around like a ball. Just like kick it like a baby and pass it around. All right, great. So, and now we're going to, let's see, where am I? Okay. We're going to buckle up again. Buckle up your seatbelts. We're going to go fly to another place in the world. And we are going to fly to I don't know where it is. It's supposed to be, I'm going to Indonesia. I'm trying to find Indonesia. Oh, here. Okay, this is where Indonesia is. Okay, so, thank you for respecting my cloth. So when one of my other friends went to Indonesia, this is what she brought back. And it's the same kind of thing. The islands of like Hawai'i and Indonesia, it's like, it's very hot, it's near the middle of the earth, the equator. And so it gets really hot there because it's the closest to the sun. So I think that's why like all the things that they brought back are things that are light, like very thin, and you can wrap them and it's a lot of fun. So again, this is the same kind of method. You just wrap it around. And actually this part, this green part is supposed to show. So let me see, because this part doesn't have the green. So I'm actually wearing. Okay, so you just wrap around. And again, if you can't tie it together, then kind of just hold it down. Okay, so then this is from Indonesia, right? So that's how it looks. Any questions so far? Okay, cool. Awesome. So I'm gonna pass this around to you so that you can feel how different it is. So this felt softer, and the texture feels smoother. Feels a little smoother. This time I'm gonna pass this way. Okay, here. Yeah. All right, and now we are going to buckle up our seatbelts again, and then we are going to fly off to another place. Called, we are going to Burma. Here's Burma. So that's where Burma is. Now Burma, again, it's really hot. All my friends are girls, so they give me girl clothes. Sorry, I don't know. But interestingly enough, even though this design is a woman's dress, even the men in Burma, traditionally, they would wear this in their waist. Now you're wondering, gosh, this looks so big and it can't wrap around. I mean, look, it can't wrap, how do you wear this?
You step
in it. Good, great. So you step in it, but look, it's still gonna fall if I let go of my hands. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna have? Okay, so this is what they do. So they you see the seam where they closed the gap and sewed the two pieces of cloth together? They fold it over, and then they roll it down so that they hide this black part. So if you notice that up here there's a black line, and down here there's no black line. Okay, so that's what's going on here. You're trying to fold it down so you hide the black part. Okay, so traditionally in Burma, men and women wore these, but this design is a woman's design, a girl's design, because it's purple and pink. So that's how it stays in. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah, great. Okay, so I'm gonna pass this around as well. And this time I'm gonna pass it this way. All right, so this is from Burma. All right. Okay, so now we are going to buckle up again to another. Buckle up. We're gonna fly again. Buckle up. Okay, great. Awesome. Now, again, raise a hand and the middle finger and the fourth finger. Put down, and we're going to fly. And we are going to fly to, Thailand. Okay, so Thailand is over here. Now this is a ceremonial dress. skirt. And so notice that, so unlike the other dresses or skirts, these have strings, and this actually allows me to tie it around my waist. So so ceremonial means like, you know, like people wear it to special occasions. I'm not wearing it to a special occasion right now, so I'm actually not supposed to wear it. So I just wanted to show you them. So yeah, so this is how you would sew it in the back. Yeah, so I have the strap together, and then I could just tie it around. And like you would tie shoelaces, hopefully. Okay, so and then I might, you know, hide it somehow, and have something on top of it and so forth. So this is how it looks.
Good.
So this is from Thailand. So all these places.
You guys have a seat, please. That you.
Okay, I need to untie this.
You sit down.
Okay, so all these places are in a place called Asia. Okay, so I'm in a continent called Asia. Okay, so this one, again, you can please be gentle with it and
you need to sit down.
Pass it around.
You can sit
nicely. That way they will fall off. Okay, and this time I'm gonna pass it this way. All right, so now we are gonna buckle up. We are going to buckle up. Okay, good, great. And then raise the hands. And then your middle finger goes down and your fourth finger, and you're going to fly. And you're gonna fly. And we are going to fly to another place called India. Okay. Yeah, so India. Okay, I've been showing you a lot of skirts. So this I'm gonna show you a top, something that you can wear on top. So let's see. So, oops, that's my pickup TT and. Okay, hold on. Excuse me. Okay, so this is a top. Oh, you know what? I'm wearing a top from Thailand. I forgot. So pretend you're still in Thailand before you get left for India. This is actually a blouse that my mom had 50 years ago. So even before I was born. So this is how it looks. Okay. All right. Okay. Now we're in India. All right. And okay, so this is a top from India, and let's see. So it's, again, the fabric is very light because India, it can be very hot. We're still in the very hot places.
Oh, can be cool.
And they have a lot of embroidery. If you see, like, you know, they have designs on there. So while in the other places, like, they dye the fabric, the design on the. On the clothes, like India, they have sewed it here in this top. Okay, so this is made of cotton, and if you wanted to feel it, that's fine too. I'm gonna pass around. So let's see. So this one, I will pass around. This way. Okay, so again, you can feel it. It feels kind of like the one from Hawai'i. All right, so now we're going to buckle up again, and we are going to leave Asia. All right, so all these places were in Asia. Okay, so now we're gonna buckle up. Yay, okay, great. And then we're gonna fly. We're flying fingers, the middle finger and the fourth finger down, and okay, and we're going to fly to, we are going to fly to Africa. So the first place we're going to fly to is, let's see, West Africa. So this is West Africa. This is West Africa. I brought a book on African textiles. Remember that we're looking at textiles, right? Awesome. So Yes. So the African textiles. So similar to Asia. Now I'm going to show you, like, so in the Southwest they were using their hands and looms, like two sticks and strings. And then in Asia they were printing the designs, dyeing it, and sewing it, and so forth. And so in Africa, one of the places in West Africa, they create a design and they print it. So it's the same design. It's kind of like a rubber stamp, like some of the stamps that you've been using, like A, B, C, and the letters. Like it stays the same no matter how many times you print it. It's the same shape and design and art. So same thing. They create something that a design on a screen. I think this is some kind of screen printing. And then after they've created the design, then they put the ink over it and they put it over the cloth. So it looks like he's, you know, if you look at the cloth, it looks like it's been stamped, right? Doesn't it? Like a lot of the same kind of shapes, same kind of design. So in the next few pages, we see that too. Like they just, it's kind of like taking a big rubber stamp and, you know, they're stamping that design. So this is a print, they print their clothes. And so this is another popular design where there's flying birds. This is West Africa. So there, you know, you see those prints? Yes? And then they might even, instead of shapes and this looks like an eye, like they might even have a person or a famous person or something where they're printing the next design. And here's a really complicated one. Really, lots of designs. So there's a spider, right? And then you see the same spider over here, the same spider over here, and there's a lot of things that are the same, but they make it in different places, and they somehow still design it so that it all fits in the same cloth. So this is West Africa. And then we're going to fly. Okay, buckle our seatbelts again. We are going to, okay, and fly fingers. Okay, and we are going to fly to East Africa and South Africa, they said. So this is South Africa. This is South, the southern part of Africa. And then this is the eastern part of Africa. This is east. This is south. Okay, so they're going to tell us about different designs from those areas too. 104. All right. So now we are going. This woman is wearing a kanga, and this is, I think, in Tanzania, which is East Africa. And so there are a lot of lines. If you see, there's lots of lines and it's a tight wrap. So the bottom, the skirts, are similar to a lot of what I already showed you. It's wrapped, you know, they round around. And then the tops too, you can see that it's made of one cloth and there's somehow wrapping around into one top. And then here's more milk cloths where they printed. It's a lot of printing going on here. And it gets more, so there's a lot of shapes. There's a lot of shapes and there's even writing in different languages that they might be putting it on the cloth to print it on the cloth. Oops. And it can they use a lot of bright colors too. They can be using a lot of bright colors. And here's a tree with mangoes. And here's a picture of people long ago who wore these kinds of clothing. Yeah, so lots of different shapes, right? Okay, so now we're going to buckle up. Okay, and then we're going to fly, and we are going to fly to North Africa. So this is north. This is the upper part of Africa. North Africa. So North Africa, promise you this will be the last part of the book I'll be showing you before I show you some more stuff. So here's a woman's wrap. Again, a lot of different designs, a lot of shapes and lines, and there's a lot of colorful symbols, animals, and things like that. And that's lots of shapes, lots of lines. And is this interesting? Like going into learning about different cloths? Okay, so now we are going to buckle up again, and we are going to fly to the last place. So find your fingers again, and put your middle finger down, and your fourth finger down, and then we are going to fly, and this is the last place that we're going to fly to, which is Nigeria. So this is where Nigeria is. This is where Nigeria is.
Nigeria, I know Nigeria.
So, from Nigeria, now I've been showing you a lot of clothes, and I wanted to show you a head wrap. So this is a head wrap. This is a cloth that people use to wrap their heads. And I'm not going to show you how to wrap your head because I don't know how to do it very well and have it stay on my head. But just imagine that you can wrap this around your head, okay? So I'm going to pass this around because this is hand-woven. So you can put it this way. So you can touch how it feels like. And it's in Nigerian. Yeah. It's the colors of the Nigerian flag, which is green and white.
Yeah.
And then now I get to show you some of the clothes that our children might wear. So in Nigeria, people wear clothes for different things. There's everyday clothes that you wear, and then there are clothes that you wear to special occasions, but a ceremonial clothes. So this is a ceremonial cloth. Let's see. I have to figure out which part is which. Because this has the, this is a shirt that Titi actually wore when she was a baby. Yes, this is what Titi wore when she was a baby. This is the top. And then this was the bottom because it has these straps. So this was the bottom that she wrapped it around her waist. Okay? And then she had something for her head too. Somebody helped her wrap her head. So this is what a girl would wear to a ceremony. So I'm going to pass this around. So you can feel, and it's hand woven, every stripe, hand sewn, it's handmade. So every part of this, somebody actually did it from a machine. Okay, so this one I'm going to pass. This is hand sewn. Okay. And then here's another thing that Titi wore when she was a baby. Like this is the top, this is a shirt. And then here's another different color. And these are pants. Actually, you know what? I think this is what Ayo wore when he was a baby. Titi's brother. So this is different shirts.
Who wore that one, Gloria?
Ayo. Oh, this one?
No, the first one.
The first one? Oh, Ayo. Ayo. Yeah, because Titi was a little bit, or maybe it's Titi. I think it's TT, sorry. It's TT because of the lace. Yeah, this was TT's. And this was ours. Yeah. Actually, a lot of these will probably fit UK at this point. I'm going to pass this way. Okay. And then these are more. Okay, so these are. So those are casual clothes. Now, these are ceremonial clothes because of the fabric. It's a little bit smoother to the touch. So I don't want these to people's birthday parties or weddings or ceremonies. I mean, birthdays, weddings, anniversaries. Those are special occasions. So these are ceremonial.
Is that from your country or your husband's
country? My husband's country. We're in Nigeria right now. Okay. So I'm gonna pass this around just so you can feel like how a ceremonial pose would be. Okay. The feel of the ceremonial pose. Yeah. So the rest I'm not gonna pass around because of time. So here's another. There's her hands. And here's the matching top. So you see that there's a lot of clothes that. They like to match the top and the bottom. And then at a ceremony, at somebody's birthday or wedding or whatever, like whole families would wear the same cloth. So it's not just the kids, even their dad, their mom, everybody would be wearing the same pattern, even though like the design of their clothes would be different.
Do you know if that one's stamped or woven, the pattern?
Oh, these are, people, usually like each family would have their own seamstress. They would hire them, they would choose the fabric and choose the design and say, oh, here, we want this. And so then that's how they make the clothes. All these are hand-tailored. So, and then here's another ceremonial one. I can tell it's ceremonial because, again, it's a very smooth fabric. And I own everything for these because we ran out of special events for them too. I can show you more. Do you want to see more?
You want to read between? Next time, I'll read between.
I'm just going to show you designs now. Okay, so here's one design. And here's another design. Stripes. Stripes.
Hey, Carmen, or you guys? Somebody.
Yeah, so this is stripes. Here's another ceremonial design. Again, this is what Davo wore. Oh my gosh. This is a man's coat. This is a man's top. The hair goes here. The arms go here. So this is what a man wears. It looks like a big blanket too, right?
Big.
Yeah, so
guys, stop.
Yeah,
she's almost done.
Okay, that's it for. So now we're gonna buckle up again because we gotta go back to Berkeley, right? Okay, so now we're gonna buckle up. Okay, and then we're gonna raise a hand, and then we're gonna put our middle finger down and our fourth finger, and we're gonna fly, and we are going to fly back too. I'm gonna put another sticker on Berkeley. We're back home. Yay! Yay! All right, so that's it for textiles.
Good job.
Okay, go. All right, so I'm gonna take a while to.
Okay, everybody, please stand up. Let's go.